Keen Thursday on Food Talk with Sherin. I'm back with another chocolate recipe for you, and this time it's a no-bake chocolate cake. Pretty easy to make. You can ask your kids to make it for you while you sit back and enjoy this delicious treat. So let's see how we can make a no-bake chocolate cake. Let's pour some water in a saucepan. Once your water starts boiling, reduce the heat and put the bowl with the chocolate on it. I'm using the dark compound chocolate from Vanlia here. You have multiple brands available in the market, so whatever is readily available, you can use that. But make sure it's cooking chocolate, and dark chocolate is what works well for this recipe. So as your chocolate starts melting, add 100 grams of butter. You see, your chocolate is all melted now. Let's move this and keep it aside. And into this hot water, let's add half a cup of almonds and cashews. I'm just putting it into the hot water so that it blanches and we're able to quickly remove the skin of the almonds, and chopping becomes much easier. Just keep this covered while we mix the rest of the ingredients. Into our melted chocolate, we're going to add our biscuits now. So I have 100 grams of Marie biscuit. Just crush it. Even if there are a few big chunks, it's perfectly okay. And into this, I'm adding 1/4 cup of condensed milk. Mix it all nicely. The biscuits will soak up the chocolate pretty well. The almonds are blanched. You can easily remove the skin. Just roughly chop them. So let's add our chopped cashews and almonds into the chocolate mix we have prepared. Mix this again. So our cake mix is ready. I'm using a 7-inch spring foam tin to set this. You can use a 6-inch, which will give you a slightly taller cake. I've lined my cake tin with parchment paper and buttered it a little. Pouring some chocolate ganache on top, just to make a thin layer. And I'm just garnishing it with some chopped almonds. This will now go into the refrigerator for about 4 to 5 hours till it's completely set.